Friends, so from today onwards, we'll be beginning with our second unit from the syllabus, that is cascading style sheets. So let us discuss what are the contents that we're going to discuss in this unit, and then we'll be moving ahead with the basics and history of style sheets. So in this unit, we'll be discussing about, it's a very small topic basically, and very interesting as well. It is all about like, how you're going to manage your designing part, how what is your creativity level and so on. Based on that, you can design more clear forms and web pages can be designed in a more better way. So the first thing we'll be discussing about the introduction part, then we'll be discussing about history, like we discussed about HTML, the different versions that we have. Similarly, in cascading style sheet, we are currently learning CSS3, we call it as. And then we'll be discussing about levels of style sheets. Then we're discussing about selector forms, property value forms, font properties, list properties, and so on. For all this, we'll be discussing about with simple examples. We'll be discussing that, like whatever the earlier tags that we have discussed, like whether it can be, in consideration to the small tags like the bold, italic, and so on. So they were just inline tags. But later on, we discussed about the major things like the lists. Then we discussed about the tables. And then we discussed about the form and its input tags and so on. Text area and all those things were discussed. So when you want to put these different elements on a web page or on a web, how good you can put it them? Like HTML provides some set of basic tags. But it will not, it is, we know that HTML is just for the presentation of the information, but we want to make it more user-friendly, not only just in terms of user-friendly, but we want to add some designing part to it. We want to give some colors. We want to change the font styles. We want to make it appear in a more beautiful way, we can say, in short. So to do that, the HTML provides the cascading style sheets. Basically, technically, we can say that cascading style sheet is not just HTML, but the cascading style sheet can be considered as a part of HTML document. So whenever you want to use the cascading style sheet, the basic thing required is the HTML document. So once we have HTML documents and say few elements, like few tags, if you have, to those tags, you can apply some style sheets. So this is the basic introduction. So let me ask you one simple question. What is the meaning of cascade in even simple terms? Can somebody tell me what is the meaning of cascade? Yes, any answers for the meaning of cascade? What is the meaning of cascade? Anybody?
Joining. Joining.
Yes. Joining, okay. Any other answers? Like he said, joining, or we can consider it as like, if you consider a simple example of waterfall. Okay, so in that, we can have the different levels, or we can say consider like layers. So similar to that, in case of HTML, we want to have the different elements, like we can have the paragraph, we can have heading tags, tables, list, and so on. So for these different tags that we have discussed, we want to apply some styles. Like it can be used to give different font properties like font sizes. We want to give some background for the entire web page. We want to add an image and we want to adjust its length and width and so on. So basically to add more attractiveness or to make it more user friendly, we can include the cascading style sheet, or we use this style sheets. So that is the basic introduction about the style sheets. And then coming to the history of it. So the CSS1 specification was developed in 1996. Earlier to this, we didn't have the style sheets. We had just the actual HTML, just a simple HTML document we had, and whatever tags that were specified and simple properties like making it bold, italic, underline, and so on. Only these were available. But when we wanted to have more options to display the information. Basically, we use HTML to display the information or display the content on a web page in a more better way. So to do that, we required this, we wanted a special tool or a special language where we can do it in a separately without mixing the HTML. So we can say that technically, CSS is not technically HTML, but can be embedded in the HTML documents. That means whatever the HTML documents that we had, in that we are going to include this CSS. So this was the first version that we had, that is CSS 1 specification was developed in 1996. And later in 1998, CSS 2 was developed, and I mean, it was released inside, in fact, and then CSS 3 is on its way. I mean, before this textbook that given added, it is the CSS 3 is on its way. But around it in 2011, CSS 3 was perfectly approved by the World Wide Web Consortium. Like whether it is the CSS or whether it is JavaScript and so on, all this related to the World Wide Web Consortium. So that is the organization which will approve the release versions. Like recently we have got the Windows 11. Okay, it has been released 2 days back. So like all the releases that we had, it was under development. Like in the 2015-16, Windows 10 was released. But later on, after using it, it will be, I mean, it was under development, and then they will release it at, it has been foolproof. That means it has been verified with all the things that are there. Similarly, from 2016 onwards, Windows 11 was under development, and recently they have released the latest version. And those who are having the Windows 10, they can update themselves. Similarly, CSS3 was on its development, and in 2011, probably it got finalized by the World Wide Web Consortium. So what CSS provides basically? CSS provides the means to control and change presentation of HTML documents. Like we can have in the HTML documents, like we discussed the elements, like it can be widgets, text boxes, list, and so on. So to make them more, or to give them more meaning, or to control these objects in a more better way, we use this CSS. And style sheets allow you to impose a standard style on a whole document or even a whole collection of documents. So when you start using this style sheet, it is not only just meant for only one particular HTML document. It can be applied for multiple documents itself. Like it is just like a creating a function, like in C program, I guess you have studied the function. So once you create the function, you can use it n number of times. Like for example, you create a function to calculate two numbers. So for that, you will write the function. And when you want to send different parameters, so you can call the same function multiple times. Are you getting me, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So once you return this particular function, whenever it is required, you pass the parameters, you call that function, you use it. So similar to this in CSS also, once we specify the designing part, or once we specify the attributes and property values, like it can be for colors, images, and so on, once you have written that, whenever it is required, you can use it multiple times. So style sheets allow you to impose a standard style on a whole document or even a whole collection of documents. It can be applied for one single document, and it can be applied for the multiple documents as well. That is the most basic advantage of having the cascading style sheet. Style is specified for a tag by the values of its properties. So in the earlier case also, in the HTML, we have discussed, like we had the attributes, we had the tags, and for the tags, we will specify some attributes. So this is also similar to like applying the attributes as well with their some properties values. So let me go back to our same example. So this was the earlier example that we had discussed in the HTML. Like we had different tags like bold, italic, underline, emphasize, strong, and so on. But these were the few basic tags that were supported by the HTML. But what if I want to make the entire paragraph bold, or if I want to make this repetition? Okay, whenever I use a paragraph, I want to make that entire paragraph as bold. Next, I have another paragraph. In that paragraph, I want to make that entire font size as 20 points. I want to make the font color as different. So when you want to have these different types of expectation or these different type of colors or images, or if you want to change the properties of that, then we require this CSS cascading style sheets. Are we getting it, everyone? Yes, are we following it?
Yes,
any
sir.
Doubts here?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts here?
No, sir.
So the next thing that we'll be discussing is about the levels of style sheets. So this is very much important. I want you to write down the syntaxes as and when we are discussing. So it will be very easy for you to understand the things. So then what are the levels of style sheets? Like we discussed, the main basic thing itself suggests that it is the cascade. Okay, cascade means it can be like levels or different stages, we can say. So the CSS provides three levels of style sheets. Three levels of style sheets in order from lowest level to the highest level. So three levels we have: lowest, middle, and the highest level. So those are called as the inline, document level, and extension level. So what are the three levels of style sheet that we have? Inline style sheets, document level style sheets, and extension level style sheets. Now, coming to the inline style sheets, we will discuss one by one with simple examples. So as we know that style sheets are basically meant for designing purpose or to give some property values, how we can give them. So the first, we will understand the basics of it, then we will go ahead with the example. So inline style sheets apply to the content of a single HTML element. So what is an HTML element? What do you mean? What is the meaning of HTML element? We have discussed in the first unit. Any example for HTML element?
Tags.
Very good. Only tags or the contents of tags also are included in HTML element?
The contents of tags are the attributes and their values also.
Very good. So the if I take a paragraph tag, the paragraph tag including the content that I have written and the attributes that are given, everything together, we can call it as the HTML element. So in case of inline style sheet, it will be applicable to only that particular element. It can be a paragraph, it can be a header, and so on and so forth. Similarly, then we have a document level style sheet applied to the whole body of a document. Like, to give a simple example, let us consider the same PPT itself. Okay, so if I say that, if I select this entire thing and I want to increase the font size, what I can do, I can make it it is being applied to only this particular sentence. Yes or no? So this is what we call it as, like, in simple way, inline style sheet. It applied to the content of a single HTML element. So only for this single sentence, I'm applying it. Or we can also make it a, like, for if you want to make this particular word, okay, bold, you can make it as bold. So it will be applicable to only that particular word or to only that particular sentence. But what is, we have document level style sheets applied to the whole body of the document. So if I do this, if I select this entire, say, control A, and then if I make this font as 18, then what is happening? It is applicable to the entire document itself. So like this, similarly in CSS also, we have the inline style sheets and the document level style sheets. And then the third one that we have is the external style sheets. But the hierarchy, the preference, or we can say the priority will be given to the inline, then the priority will be to document level, and then it will be given to the external level. So we will discuss these two first, and then we can go ahead with the external. So where this inline style sheets appear, so they will basically appear in the tag itself. So we have to write that tag, whether it can be H1, H2, H3, so on, or it can be paragraph and so on. So for that particular tag, we have to include the style properties and their respective values. And document level style sheets appear in the head of the document. So let's take the example and then understand the inline style sheet. So I have taken a simple program here and I have named it as css1.html. Like we say that what we have discussed earlier, CSS is not technically HTML, but can be embedded in the HTML document. Embedding in the sense one inside the other. Okay, like we can put one inside the other. So that'd be called as the embedded system. Like we can have embedded system. It can be combination of many things. So similarly, in case of cascading style sheets as well, basically it will be a HTML document itself. But within the HTML document, we will be including this CSS. So I have written a simple program here, HTML head and so on body. Then I have used the H1 tag. For that, I have specified some styles. And then I have closed this tag and so on and so forth. So let's discuss about how the inline style sheets will appear and what will be the syntax for the inline specification. So whenever you want to give or when you want to use the inline style specification, the syntax goes like this. First you have to write a tag name, first you have to write space style, okay, then equal to, in double quotes you have to write, start with this double quotes and it will end here. So property 1 colon value 1. All this property as well as value will be in small letters. Then put this semicolon, then property 2 value 2, and so on, property 3 value 3, property 4 value 4, and so on, and at the end property n value n. So it depends how many properties you want to use it for that particular element. It can be a paragraph, it can be h1, and so on. Are we getting the syntax, everyone? For inline style, yes, specification, sir. What is the syntax now? We have to use style equal to property 1. This can be like say font size, or it can be say color, it can be say font family, and so on. Then for that, a particular value will be there, that value to give, and then put the semicolon. If you want to have second property, you can use the second, followed by that value, and so on. And like this, you can specify different properties for that particular element. So let's see how we have applied this. So we'll copy the same syntax so that you will come to know. Just put this in the comments. So how to use this? I have created H1 style equal to font family. So like it can be Arial, Sans Serif, Helvetica, like this. We are going to study this in detail. Okay, that is again the coming class we'll be discussing about what are the different font families are there, font sizes, how to mention the font size and so on. As of now, you just understand the syntax and followed by how to give that. The first thing we have is the font family. So like it is a property. So for the H1, I have written a information that welcome to CSS. For this particular information that I want to display on the web page, I want to give the property 1. So what is my property 1 font family? I want this font family to be make it as Arial. Okay. And then, so the Arial becomes what is the value. Next, what is my second property? Then put a semicolon, font size. Okay. Font size is my second property, colon. What should be the value for it? I want to give the value as 50 point. This again, we will be discussing it. Can be given in points, pixels, percentages, and so on. And then we have the third property called as the color. So there is no restriction that how many properties you want to give. As many as you can give, but for in this example, we are considering, we are giving 3 properties and then followed by the value. So color, I want to make it as red, put the semicolon, and then your double quotes will terminate. And then your actual opening tag. So H1 opens here. Usually how we will write H1, we write H1, we close it. But whenever you want to use the inline style, H1 space, give the style and give all the values and other things. And then you can close this tag. And then after this, whatever information you want to write, you can write it. Are we following it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Doubts here? Others?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So is the syntax clear to everyone? This is syntax. Syntax,
yes, you have
to remember. If you remember syntax, giving the I properties and values is very simple. So style equal to double quotes open and double quotes terminates. In that property 1, colon value 1, then semicolon property 2, comma value 2, and so on. So this is the syntax. So as we say that inline appears inside the tag. Inline, we call it as inline. Why we call it as inline? Because it appears. Inline style sheet apply to the content of a single HTML element, or inline style sheets appear in the tag itself. So we are giving the style for this particular tag, you can see. So now I will run this. Welcome to CSS. So we have made it as font family, font size, and so on we have given, and it will appear here. So now if I want to take another paragraph, say for example h2 style, okay, I want to say just font size. As of now I'm taking only this so that you can understand it easily, but there are different attributes or I mean properties and values you can apply. Font size, I will say 20 points, and then we can close this. Only one attribute is enough for me, so we'll only close this, and then we'll say that before, and I will close this. Here I will use a br. Okay, br tag I have used. So now what will happen? Whatever I have used h2 for this, only font size will be applied. Just we'll go back to the program. So this is how we can specify the inline tags. Are you all following it? Everyone? Any doubts here? And this is not only for the h1, you can use it for a paragraph as well. Suppose say that you want to apply it for a paragraph, you can apply it for a paragraph as well. As of now, we are discussing what is the meaning of inline and what is the meaning of document and what is the meaning of external as of now. For which all in the tags you can apply the inline and external and so on, that we will discuss it later on. But as of now, just remember that how to give the inline style sheet or how we can apply the inline style sheet. Are we getting it, everyone? So then you may ask, like when we have discussed this earlier tags, like if you have a paragraph or this is a heading and so on, in this situations, what will be the properties for that? In this situations, whatever is the properties defined by the browser, that is the default value will be considered. Suppose here I'm not mentioning anything. Okay, I have not mentioned the size, or neither I have mentioned the font size and so on. Then what it will take and how it will display. In such situations, it will take the default values based on depending on the browser. So if you take this example, so here we are clearly mentioning that I want the style that font size should be 20 points. If I don't specify this, by default, whatever is the font size defined by that particular browser. Again, it depends whether you are using Chrome, which version you are using, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, and so on. Depending on the browser and depending on which version you are using, it will take the default values if you don't specify anything. But when you say, if you're specifying something, whatever you specify, only that will be considered. Are you getting it, everyone? And sometimes if you use some invalid values, like for example, if you use a paragraph style and say something 200 points if you give, then it will be there is a bound of how much points you can use. What should be the point size? Like for example in PPT, okay, if I select this, and there is a maximum limit, you can say 96 and so on. Beyond this, you cannot use it. So if you use some invalid values, then it will be discarded by the browser, because browser cannot apply that particular value. Are you clear with this, everyone? Yes. Any doubts here?
Yes, sir.
Shall we go ahead with the next one?
Yes, sir.
And the next one is very important. It is a little different from the inline one. That is the document level style sheets apply to the whole body of a document, or we can say document level style sheets appear in the head of the document. So to use this document level, few things we have to do. So what few things we have to do? Let's understand this. So whenever we want to specify like document style specification, we have to use a tag called as the style tag. So this is the new tag that appears, I mean, that we are discussing, and we have to use this style space type equal to text slash CSS, and then we have to give the rule list, and then we have to close this style tag. Okay, and where this will appear? This will appear inside the head section. Okay, this particular style tag, we are what we are mentioning, style type equal to text slash CSS and rule list followed by the style. This basically appears inside the head section of the HTML document. So here we are mentioning that style type, it can be text slash CSS. That means we are indicating to the browser that we want to use document level CSS. See, why it is mentioned, why we need to mention, because there are some different types of documents as well. It can be JavaScript and so on. It can be XML and so on. So for that, to avoid a confusion, we are indicating to the browser that we want to use the properties or whatever we want to use that is meant for, or that is for the CSS. So we have to specify it as text slash CSS. Are you all getting it, everyone? And where this will appear now? This will appear inside the head section. Okay, so I have taken another example. Okay, so usually this will be your head section, and before you close the head section, okay, you have to include this style type equal to text slash CSS, close the style tag, and then this we call it as the rule list. This we call it as what? We call it as the rule list, and then we close the type. Are you all getting it? What is the syntax? Syntax goes like this: style type equal to text slash CSS, rule list, then close the style. And where this tag will appear? Where you have to include this tag? In the HTML document, where it will appear? Just now we discussed where this tag will appear in the head. HTML document, in the head section. So after the title, or you can give it before the title as well. So after the head section, usually we write the title. Once you close the title, you have to specify like this: style type equal to text slash CSS in double quotes only, close this tag, and then this we call it as the rule list, and then close the style tag. What this rule list is all about? Here we have, say, for example, here we have the rule list. Okay, so what a rule list will consist of? In inline style sheet, whatever you have done, same thing will appear, but this will appear in a different way. Like, we have something called a selector, then we have the, instead of double quotes, here we have the double quotes. Instead of double quotes, we have the opening brace, and then we have the closing curly braces, and within that we give the properties and their respective value. So these appears always in the pairs, property value pairs, we can call it them as. If property one, value one, same thing here as well. Then put the semicolon. After this also you can write, no issues. But to make you understand, usually we give it as property two, value two, property three and value three, and so on and so forth. So this is the syntax of the rule list. And what this selector? selector means it can be a tag, like for example it can be h1 h2 paragraph tag and so on. So that we call it as the selector. So we have different types of selectors that we will be discussing later on, but as of now you remember this, that how we have to use the document style specification. So the advantage of having this document style specification is, if you use this h1, okay, and if you give say font family, font size and color, wherever this h1 appears inside your document, so that all h1s this can be used. But for example, if you consider css, inline css, again I want to use a h1, okay, and again I want to give the same properties, I need to keep on typing the code again, I need to apply the same style equal to font family equal to Arial, font size equal to 50 points and so on. So this will become a tedious task. So h1 can appear 10 times, it can appear 100 times and so on. So every time writing this will become very difficult. Okay, it is as good as like for the PPT, like we have discussed like in this case. Okay, for if you want to give the same property for the all the sentences, you can select everything and you can directly give it out. So that will be more better, instead of making this as bold first, this sentence, again this sentence as bold and so on, it will take a lot of time. So select all the things and do it. Similarly here, in the document level, when you use this selector, and then you, when you give properties and their values, and then whenever you use the H1 tag, everywhere this will appear. Are we getting it, everyone? Yes. Are you all following it? I'll just remove this now.
Yes, sir.
So in this case, whenever you use any content, like any layer tag like H1, no need to specify style here. Whatever style you wanted to specify, that already specified here. Okay, so welcome to CSS. So that this means what? Whenever I use H1, and whatever properties are given, I use the property as font family equal to Arial, font size as 50, color as red. This is going to be applicable for all the H1 elements, for all the H1 tags. Okay, so I will just run this. And this I have given it as css_2.html. Again, you can observe that this is not a .css file, it is just a normal HTML file. Inside that we are embedding the CSS. We have embedded. CSS is included. Are you getting it, everyone? So the advantage of earlier one with this one, for example, I want to use again one more H1, that vaccination is started in our college. And for this sentence, particular sentence, I want to use same property values. I want to make it say font family as Arial, font size as 50, color as red, and so on. I will put PR tag here. That means what? Wherever I use H1, these properties and their respective values will be applicable. I'll just run this now. Can you see it? So are you able to get the advantage of having the document level style sheet over the inline? Everyone? So this is what I was supposed to tell. So if you write this once, you can use it multiple times. Write once, use it multiple times. Are you all getting it?
Yes, sir.
Like in the earlier case, for example, say I want to use a paragraph, and in that I have written this. Suppose say that I want to have a paragraph, and for that paragraph also I want to use the same thing. So in that case, no need to write like this. Okay, I have to use P and then colon and curly braces and this is not required. even though this works fine, but instead of that, what you have to do, you have to put, instead of this, I will just say H1 comma P. That means I want to make font family as Arial, font size as 50, color as red for H1 as well as the P. So wherever P appears in my entire document, I can use it. So instead of, no need to write this multiple times. But whereas in this case, if I want to apply the same font family and font size and so on for the paragraph as well, I need to write it again and again. But in this case, write once, use it multiple times. So instead of this, what I will do, I will make this as P, then I will close this paragraph. Whatever I have given for this, same thing will appear for this as well. Are you getting it? Since this is H1, it will take its apart from this, okay? Apart from this, there are some other attributes that are hidden behind the scene. So those will be considered by the default values by the browser. But this is the paragraph tag, and for that we have applied this. Are we clear with this, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Instead of this, if you want to make it for H1 and H2, okay, so you can use it for H2 as well. And then I will make it as H2, and then I will close this. It is not only for the first H1 and first H2. Even if I use H1 again here somewhere, okay, if I use H1 100 times, every 100 times, these properties will be applicable. Every 100 times, 200 times, wherever you use H2, these properties will be applicable. Just run this again. This is the beauty of using the CSS. Any doubts here? Anybody is having any doubt? So in the syntax, if you remember, we call it as the rule list. So rule list is nothing but whatever you have used in the inline style property values, same thing we will be having, but we call it as the selector. Selector is nothing but a attribute. I mean, it can be a tag, it can be H1P and so on. And then open curly braces, close the curly braces. Within that, you have to specify the properties and the respective values, but don't use the double quotes here. Instead of double quotes, we'll be having, if you compare this syntax, we had the style here. Instead of that, we will be specifying the tags, and then we do not have equal to symbol here. We had double quotes. Instead of double quotes, we have the opening curly braces, and rest things remain same. Property 1, colon, value 1, semicolon, property 2, value 2, semicolon, and so on. And then at the end, property and value, and then closing braces. Here we had the double quotes. That is the only difference between the syntax. But this is a must, and this should appear inside the head section. You cannot skip this part. So we are trying to inform to the browser that the HTML document that we are using, the text that we are going to display on this, we are going to use this as text/CSS. Any doubts here till now, whatever we have discussed? Everyone is able to understand the syntaxes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will add another 2 minutes and then we can wind up with the session. So now, suppose that we have the paragraph tag here. Okay, I will just make it as a paragraph tag. And I will have a paragraph. And then I want to make the, for this entire paragraph, I want to keep font family as same, font size as 20, and color as red. Okay. So in such situations, instead of taking this entire font family and color and so on, what I will do, I will take paragraph P, style. Okay. How to give the inline style equal to double quotes, font size, colon, I want to make it as 20 points. Okay. And then put the semicolon here. So try to observe this now. So this is what earlier font size I had given. What is the font size? 50. And then what I made as 20. So what will happen? What will be the output? Can you think of what can be the output? How this will appear now? Will this appear with black color?
Or the font size will be 20, sir.
And what about the other things? Color and font family will be?
It will be Arial and red.
Sir, color will be black. Color right.
Okay, there are different answers that we will discuss now.
Sir, color and font family will remain same, only size will change.
So this means what? Okay, let me take up this. I have not made it as P, I will make it as P now. Let's observe it. So what is being happened here for the paragraph? What I am doing, font family, it will take it as Arial. Color, it will take it as red. But whereas font size, it will take it as 20. And you may ask why it is not taking 50, even though you have mentioned it as 50. Because the priority goes like this. Priority will be always given to the inline. Then it will be given to the document level. Then it will be given to the external level. That is the priority. So here, if you understand, the three levels of the style sheets in order from lowest level to the highest level are inline, document level and external level. So this is how it works. Even though we have mentioned the font size as 50, but inline, okay, inline style, what you applied it as font size equal to 20. So first, how the browser works, let us understand. Browser will work like this. It will open this paragraph tag and it will check, is there any style is been specified? If the style is specified, then it will take this particular style. Okay, and then it will take, is there any document level style applied? Yes. So what document style level applied? Font family Arial, okay, font size 50, but already we have mentioned in line that the font size should be 20. So it will not take this one. It will skip this and then it will take color as red. Are you getting it, everyone? How it works? Are we clear with this?
Yes, sir.
To know what styles have been applied, you can just go to the inspect element. Okay, and then if you can click on this properties, you can see how the styles have been applied. So you can see, can you see here this font size equal to 50 point has been scratched. I mean, it has been, we have written the line over there. Why it is happening? Because the browser reads the HTML element in the tags in from the inline. If inline 20 is specified, it will take that. Otherwise, it will take the document level. Are you able to understand this? And you may observe there are some other also display equal to block, margin block start, and so on. So these are the some of the by default properties. Okay, are we clear with this, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Anybody has any doubts? So I want you to try whatever the earlier documents, I mean HTML programs you have taken. In that, I want you to try with different styles, like only with fonts as of now, because we are not studied in detail about what are the font families, what are the font sizes and so on. These, like whatever we have discussed, these you can try it for H1 paragraph, H2 and so on. For different tags, you can try with this. Will you be able to do this? Everyone?
Yes.